Hello and welcome back to the channel, and welcome back to Project 406. I was going to do this video before the weekend, but I worked late on Friday and I just wanted to get away. So yeah, I've getting most of the work done on this car. Hopefully it'll be getting MOT'd, I hope, sometime early this week, if I get a chance to fit it in between work. So fingers crossed I'll get it tested. So obviously, as you can see, I've just got the pollen filter. That's my error. If you look on my videos before, and I mentioned taking the wipers off to change the pollen filter, I was getting mistaken for my MGZT, which is like a Rover 75. With them, you've got to remove the wipers to remove it. So yeah, I've got the pollen filter out. It doesn't look too bad. Still gonna change it, 2 minute job. But as I've mentioned in my previous video as well, I'm still gonna have to remove the wipers to a degree or pop them off the spindles because they're totally out of line. I'll show a better here. This one is catching all of this and the driver's side one is far too high. And I'm more than likely I think it is catching up here somewhere. If it isn't, it's still coming too far across. So I need to adjust them. So I'll get that pollen filter done, wipers, fuel filter. I've already in my previous video shown you what I've done here. Obviously somebody commented and said that math sensor wouldn't fit. I know that, and that was documented in my last video that I just uploaded over the weekend. As these have got two screws in it rather than two open ends. But it's been cleaned, it's best I can do with it. And I'm gonna just pause the video here and get a light. Out down here, and there's a pipe that's coming off that, which is blanked off, but somebody told me that was for the air dozer. I'm not that familiar with these engines. I'm just trying to find where the pipe was. It was down there. This is it here. That one nicely with a little this, and just comes down to here. And it's got a. So if anybody could just confirm that for us, I believe the air dozer is just like what our class is, like a throttle flap on a diesel. Probably aids like shut off and stuff, like shut off judder. But according to some people, it's something to do with a little vacuum butterfly valve. I think almost divert air to the intercooler, but I can't see no, unless it's under this, which I haven't took off yet. But that pipe doesn't look like it would stretch very far, or to the back of the air filter, I don't know. So if anybody wants to comment on that, feel free. Either send us a message on YouTube or write it on the Facebook. So yeah, like I said, that's pretty much under the bonnet. We'll move over to here now. The bearings all being done. I've cleaned that disc up a bit. Put the new drop link on, like I mentioned, because last year's MOT, that was advised. So while it was off, it was, I may as well just change it. And as you can see on the front, as well as I've shown in the previous videos, I've greased all the front subframe. And we'll go underneath and I'll show what's been going on. As you can see, last week I got it all finished. I've greased all the subframe. Wasn't in bad condition, actually. I just wanted to just add a bit extra protection to it. Well, that's what it was. It was a little beep. Or I don't know who's been on with a chisel on the drain plug for the gearbox, but it was a little beep on that. And for some reason it was loose. So I've tightened that up. And the right stupid idea, can you see up there in the back? I don't know if that'll zoom in. It's just zooming in on that. I'll try and, you know there, that's your fill plug, which is right up against the subframe at the back of the steering rack. That was fun just trying to just top it up. Didn't actually need barely anything, but still, the fact that it had been leaking was a cause of concern. So that's sorted. Well, obviously, we've done the bearing, greased everything up on there. That sort of new drop link go to the back. As you can see, everything under here has been coated. Managed to get, I had a second hand tyre lying around this side. I got a brand new tyre on this side, so it's got two more or less new back tyres. Fully greased rear subframe and rear arms. As I said, I've adjusted the back drums inside the discs. They work perfect now. Been around all the brake pipes, coated those. So yeah, it's more or less ready to go for test. Just two little areas. I found out why the wings are starting to go, because these little grommets here have got holes in them. So all the water's been flinging onto the inside of the wings. And that's, so I'm gonna try and cover those holes up. Actually, better shown on this side where the wheel's off, see? So I'm gonna try and cover those up so it doesn't get no worse. As you can see, the way I always go, I actually ran out of wax oil, so I had to use copper grease. It's not my normal way, but it's just a bit better to have everything copper greased up. I don't care what people say about it, I've never had any bother with it for 20 years, so it works, and I've never had it fail. As you can see, this car's got a DPF, 20-year-old car with a DPF. So yeah, more or less ready for test. I'll document another video. I've been around, as you can see, I've tidied up a few little areas. Oh, hold on, I forgot the main points. I put the little patch of weld into here. I've just stone chipped that up just to put a bit of protection on to where it had the little tiny, like, sort of drain hole size. So I cut that out, put a patch in, put some filler over. You know, welded a patch in, grind it down, put filler over. And I think that looks a nice job. And this side has not been done by me. It wasn't done that kind of tidy. So what I had to do was just grind down the little bits of weld on it and just cover them over. It's not perfect, but it looks better than it was. If you look on the first video, it's perfectly solid. Just didn't look very nice, that was all. So yeah, that's more or less ready. Had a new exhaust on the back not long ago. Still starting to rust in the last 5 minutes. So yeah, I'll if that's all I can really put on for now, I can get the car back on the floor. Might document doing the fuel filter. But that's all for now. I'll catch you next time. Keep watching. There'll be another video coming up soon. Like, subscribe and share. Thanks. Bye.